go looking for a new water bottle and gets it.
It's broken. He's not happy with it. That's why he sent it to the bench. It's not going in his mask. All the fans behind the goaltender here are laughing. He's shaking his head.
Christensen with his second point of the season and his second assist in this game. And our team in Isimov, with Andre DeVoe coming in to provide a little snowplow action to open things up just a little bit more. Makes it 4-2 New York.
Sidney Crosby throw a water bottle out there. Well, it was the reaction as Kunitz comes in and makes a hit here on Ekholm. A hard one going back, and the swing of the stick is what prompted that. And all of a sudden, look at Crosby with a left-handed throw. And about 40 seconds later, it's a 5-0 game.
Tie, 1-1, late second. Fleet of foot in the Penguins. They want to play man on man, and who are you going to put on that man? Marc-Andre Fleury shuffles the water bottle down, all the way down to the other end, and gets a little high five from Pickard. It says, thanks for the water, Flower. Wow, how about that? One goalie to another.
Better spot for Patrick Maroon as it went over the shoulder of Markstrom and right underneath. And there you go. Dorsett's going to get kicked out of this game. A 10-minute misconduct for that.
The water bottle squirted Patrick Maroon, who goaded him into doing it.
Okay, if I'm the Oilers here, I'd say forget about the penalty. Give him an unsportsmanlike 2-minute. I mean, this is one where a 10-minute, what does that do?
Get a shoulder in the chops.
It's those big shoulder pads.
Yeah, there you go.
Ellis, who's from Hamilton, played junior in Windsor. Yeah, he thought it was a direct shot to the head. And that's what Dan O'Rourke talking to him now. Whoa! Phil Housley saying, settle down. The Hall of Famer telling him to settle down.
The shot by TJ Oshie. And there you see.
And Pasternak's able to handle that indirect off-the-wall pass from David Krejci to get in behind. Much like the Gerby goal, where you stretch the zone to the neutral zone, you create numbers.
He seems to be okay now. And yeah, he even gets in the act, as the guy showed in the studio, with a little water spray as he left the ice early after this scrum was going on at the end of the period.
Something's going on with the Lions. He's got to change the puck for this draw. But
first three shifts for Toronto, they best be ready to compete. This crowd did not sit down to the entire intermission.
Play is stopped because a water bottle came onto the ice. Did what?
Picture tells a thousand words. They weren't happy with the way the faceoff was lined up. And so Marchand throws a water bottle out, and we get a reset. Julian wasn't happy as well. He was trying to get their attention, no one paying attention, because it was too loud in the building, guys.
Get a much needed goal and a lead.
But Silverberg just snapped it from high in the right wing circle, popped the water bottle, beating the goaltender Grubauer high on the short side.
Defenseman Muzzin, his ability and assertiveness to stay on that line and not back off. I mentioned earlier with Muzzin, it was defensively at his own blue line. This time it's offensively, so he's doing it at both blue lines.
Short high side, and there aren't too many people who can deliver it like he did over the shoulder of a countrymate in Enron.
Set as he was in this game after an altercation along the boards in which Killorn apparently got squirted by the Rangers bench water, and then there was a fight, and J.T. Brown was involved in that. So now there's some fines coming out of this. You can't squirt water from the bench and then turn around and stick them.
Well, and we're not making light of it, but squirting water and sticking a guy with a stick is the same penalty. So $5,000 fine for Kevin
You
Hayes.
Squirt me, I'm going to stick you.
He still does not convinced that it didn't go in. There's both posts. Now watch the reaction of Mason. He's going to stand up. He doesn't realize that the non-goal call has happened here. And eventually, he gets up and he goes to get a drink of water while the play is coming back at him. There's both goal posts right there. And there's Mason. Almost looked like he was a little bit sore on the ice. He gets up. The play starts to go the other way, and Mason thinks it's in. There he is, going to get a drink.
I didn't know what it was either, Joel. Crazy. I was watching him going, did you think the puck was in the net? He must have.
For seven, and reaches out. Oh, he goes down. Watch the bench. There's the squirt right there, and that's what provoked it. That was Bukestad, I think.
Oh, yeah, someone got him a little wet.
Okay. All right.
I'm never going to throw water at you. You might hit me with...
I mean, Gudas lost his mind, but the referees did get this right. And the the bench minor's a good call. You can't squirt water onto a player when he's sitting down on the ice.
In Toronto, and you're a former teammate. This is what you love about Gilmore.
There's Gilmore. He unscrews the water bottle, skates away. Craig Rivé, moments later, whoops, gets a little bit wet. And you heard Wendell Clark say what a great team guy Doug Gilmore was earlier. That's a good example.
Luke Shen waffles a backhander at Bobrovsky, and Bozak stays with it and sticks it off the water bottle. Nobody is able to get to Bozak.
I can't believe I got beat at my own game. A little disappointed in myself. Usually I'm pretty aware of what's going on, but that's probably the first time I've got the water bottle in many years.
Likely be fined by the NHL for throwing a tantrum in the penalty box yesterday. Avery was launching water bottles, one of which went flying by a group of kids. The bottle smashed against the wall, soaking a family. The kid's father was enraged and went down to the box to show Avery the bottle. Avery apologized to the family and gave them a stick. But this is just not anything that Sean Avery...
Every day, get a drink of water, Mark. No, it's the other way. Green side up.
Side with 41.9 seconds remaining. What's Subban saying to Thornton, Pierre?
Subban thought Thornton sprayed some water on him, and he's gone over. He's pointing at his mask right now. He's telling Eric Furlatt, he put water up my face.
How about that reaction?
Yeah. Didn't see it. You can think whatever you want. I'll tell you one thing. There's not a team in the league that wouldn't have P.K. Subban on their team.
So to see what Corey Perry did to Jeff Connor with the water bottle the other night?
Yes.
Into his glove.
Olympic teammate.
Yep.
Getting a drink of water. There's his Olympic teammate, Jeff Carter. Watch what he does with the water bottle here. As Carter's putting the tape back, Perry fills his glove up with water. And Carter doesn't realize until he gets his hand in there. And he just tells the linesman basically what a clown this guy is.
Eddie, that's amazing skill.
We'll show you what happened. Brad Ferentz in the penalty box in Long Island. The missile, that's the bottle. Brad Isbister in the white, 15. Now they're going to come over. It's one of those classic old-time sort of a in-your-barn kind of battle. And people are just trying to get out of the way here.
Nothing against the shot and the move. But the goalie was down a way too early, and the opening shouldn't have been there.
Let's see if he squirts the fan right here.
See, he starts.
Oh, the glass fell.
There's Kevin Collins. Kevin Collins may have gotten the worst of that, but oh yeah, tied Nomi in, got some shots in.
Well, there's an example of the player being at fault there. Domi actually initiated all that.
I couldn't agree with you more, Jimmy, about what you had mentioned about the fact that the frustration builds up.
Develop here. There's a trip right there by the foot of Bozak. Not only his stick, but he got his skate, too. I mean, that's a call 100% of the time. Head goes down. You could see the reaction of Chari. Credit the Blues with keeping the play alive, but you can see the Bruins all standing still, and a bad break. The puck goes off
is littered with debris.
I mean, this reaction to St. Louis is clear, but this is a penalty all day long. The reaction of Achari hitting his head. Here's Cam Neely. Can't believe that the call wasn't made. You've got a player looking the other way.